Hello and welcome back to the channel. So it's already roughly mid-May and many of you will have your internship drive or placement drive in July end or August starting or something like that. So many of my juniors message me about how to prepare for drives, and mostly these questions revolve around three things. First is committee programming or DSA, second is projects, and the third one is CGPA. And I thought I will compress all my thoughts and share it in a single video instead of keeping on replying to everyone. So before starting, an important disclaimer here. For those of you who do not know me, I just finished my computer science degree from IIIT Hyderabad. I did my summer internship at Uber and I've been working with some startups from quite some time now. But all of these times I was on this one side of the table. That means I was giving the interviews or I was interning or I was preparing, but I never really interviewed a candidate. So my viewpoint is limited in that aspect. So if you find something which I say which is wrong or another thing which I should mention, then please do let me know in the comments. And with that said, the video will be mostly divided into three parts: project, CPDSA and CGPA. So let's get started. Okay, so let's start with the first thing, which is committee programming or DSA. And frankly, for me, both of these terms are more or less same. So if you do DSA on a decent level, you can easily approach questions on committee programming websites like Code Forces, Code Chef, HackerRank, etc. And unless you are aiming for like ICC World Finalist or like doing very hard algorithms or data structure, both of them are same. So now two questions come. First, whether you should do it, and if you should do it, then how you can approach in this limited time frame. Now, if you are aiming for on-campus internship or placement, then it is definitely required. You cannot compromise on your DSA problem solving skills, because almost all the companies which will come to your campus will have a coding room, and if you are not able to solve those questions, your project, your attitude, whatever, that will not matter. So the first thing, which is DSA, is a must. And now, if you're not aiming for on-campus, that means the companies don't come into your campus, or for any reason you want to apply off-campus, there are two things basically: off-campus in a big company, off-campus in a startup. Startup, I will tell more about that when I discuss projects. If you're applying for a big company, DSA skills are much more required now, because you will be competing with a lot more students now. So DSA skills again are required. And secondly, if you apply for big companies off campus, if you have good DSA skills, if you have good ranking on the website like Code Forces again, you can approach someone to give you referral and they would be happy to give you referrals. So DSA skills are important if it's on campus or if it's off campus and big company. Second, how you should do it. Now you have like 2 or 3 months left, and if you want to learn everything from scratch, then honestly, I don't have much idea about finishing everything from scratch in 2 or 3 months. But what I would say is, if you can afford, you can look for some courses or maybe follow geek hobbies. But I mean, that's a complete separate dedicated video I will have to make. For now, I assume that you have basic idea of what are for loops, what are recursion, what are functions, and just want to practice more. So what you can do is, there is a website which I followed, which is Internships. I'm not promoting anything. It's just what I followed. So there is a programming course or programming letter, something like that. I will attach the link in the description, and it gives the question section wise. So some questions on arrays, then trees and graphs and so on. And you can follow BFS approach there. So what I mean by BFS is basically do one question of every topic, then do the second question of every topic, and don't take this literally because some topics will be harder. So you might not be able to do this at the same speed as other topics. So, but more or less, practice all the topics together so that after 2 or 3 months you are confident enough in all the topics. So you can follow Internships. As I said, Internships is basically a smaller set of lead code, you can say, because lead code again has a lot of questions which is not feasible to do it. Internships has a limited set of questions which if you do, then you can easily crack any product based company or whatever. And there are some DSA sheets also in the market, and you can also follow them. But I would say if you can do Internships, then that's better. If you find it hard or for some reason you don't want to do Internships, then that DSA sheets will also work to some extent. So what I mean by some extent, you might not be able to crack every company, but yeah, most of the companies you will be able to crack if you do any of those famous DSA sheets which have like 200, 250 whatever questions depending on what sheet you pick. Okay, next comes the project. So many of the students have this doubt that whether they should focus on building a good project or they should focus on the DSA or CPA skills in this 2 or 3 months time frame. So again, if you are aiming for a big company on campus or off campus, then do not focus on projects a lot, because they mostly only care about your DSA skills, unless your project is like very good, which I don't think, if you're asking this question from me, you will be able to make in this 2-3 months without compromising on your DSA skills. So DSA skills are must. Now, if you're already very confident in your DSA skills, then yes, definitely go with a project. But if you're okay-showcase, then focus on your DSA skills main. DSA skills after that project. Okay. Secondly, if you are aiming to apply for some startup off campus, then I would say DSA skills does not really matter much. They do not look for any of your competitive programming, or like they don't ask those questions. Instead, most of the startups, what they do is give you a very small project which can be doable in 1 or 2 days, and they judge you on that. So all that matters is your development skills. So focus on that. And I mean, I'm saying smaller startups, but honestly, they are very good, some of them. Even I had doubt that whether should I join Uber or join some small startup like that. So hiring is very different. If you are aiming for big company, then aim for DSA skills. If you are aiming for smaller startups, aim for development. But if you are confused, what you can do is do DSA. Why I'm saying so is because your on-campus drive or your big company's hiring will be in a given time frame only. So July end or August. After that, they won't keep on hiring you. Okay. So focus on DSA for these 2-3 months. If you are able to crack a big company, or if you're not able to crack it for any reason, if you want to look for startups keep on hiring throughout the year. You won't be able to find one, you will be able to find second. But hiring in big companies are more systematic. So if you are confused right now, focus on DSA. Do DSA properly for 2-3 months. I mean, till your placement or internship season goes on. And once that is over, then you can focus on development skills, because by development skills, you will be able to crack some startup. Cool. So for projects, do not focus on projects if you have at least a little bit alignment towards getting into a big company. Now, some students say that they might get bored, and that is completely normal, because it might not be easy for you to spend your whole day for 2-3 months concentrating on CP or DSA. So yes, obviously you can pick up some projects, but as I said before, it is not important, and you are just doing it for your learning for long term. It won't help in your short term selection criteria. Now, how to approach building a project, what things you should look for, and things you should consider for long term growth is again topic for another video. Do let me know in the comments if you want that video. But just for one line, unless you are very much interested in ML, interested, don't just go away with the word. Unless you are very much interested in ML and research area, do not pick up any ML projects. Focus on normal your web dev or app dev. Okay, so normal things. Don't focus on fancy stuff unless you are interested in that area, not because the world is interested. Cool. So focus on your maybe Munchak, Django, GraphQL, CGPA, things like that. The common things which have good number of resources, good scope, good industry work, and things like that. Again, I can tell all this in detail in some other video if you want. So that's all for the project. Project is basically in the crux. Do not aim, it won't help in your internship. Focus on DSA or CP for 2-3 months. Focus on projects after that if you want to work in a startup also, or alongside you can work, but make sure you are not compromising again on your DSA time. Just do it for fun, because it will essentially help you when you do actual internship or actual job. Okay, now let's come to the third thing, which is CGPA. Obviously, you cannot change your CGPA right now, at least for your next internship or job drive. But I wanted to include CGPA in this video because most of the answers about whether CGPA matters or not are wrong. Because either they say yes, that matters, or they say no, that does not matter, depending on who you are asking, what is their CGPA, what is their job, and so on. And frankly, none of the answer is correct, and also none of the answer is wrong. So it again depends. Now, if I have 2 resumes, everything is same, both have good DSA skills, both have decent projects, obviously I will take CGPA as a criteria. So yes, CGPA matters. If you're maybe aiming for a trading company, either control or even software role, then obviously CGPA will be a criteria. And if you're maybe hoping for on-campus placements or internship, then your first selection criteria is CGPA. I mean, that is like 8 or 8.5 for non-trading companies. Trading companies don't look below 9, okay, even if you're software. So yes, CGPA matters. And again, if you get through all the rounds, even the final HR round, at the end, if they have two resumes which are very similar, they will look at things to filter them out. And CGPA might be one of them. So CGPA is the last thing to focus, assuming you have decent CGPA, like at least 8, 8.5-ish. CGPA is the last thing to focus. But that being said, if you have good DSA skills, if you have built good projects, then definitely focus on CGPA. It's obvious. It's basically like a cherry on top of a cake. But before putting on the cherry, you have to build a cake, right? So focus on your DSA skills, focus on building a project. And if all this is settled, then yes, definitely put the cherry on the top. But don't just run after the cherry without building the cake, okay? And anyways, now whatever you have done, you can't really change that. So don't get demotivated if you have low CGPA. Don't get highly motivated if you have high CGPA. Because CGPA, again, unless it's a trading company, CGPA is the last thing they will look for, if everything else is same. So if you have low CGPA, do hard work, prepare well for DSA, as well as build some projects, and show that you deserve the internship or job, rather than crying that whatever you have done for previous semesters and you do not have a good CGPA right now. Okay, so for conclusion, assuming you are a normal student, you do not have any expertise in DSA or project, you do not have any such priorities, big company or startup company, I am, for those students, give these 2-3 months for doing DSA from interview bit preferably, or if you find any good resource, then you can do that. Also share that resource in the comments for others. So focus on DSA skills. If you are bored, if you think you cannot focus your whole day, then just for interest, pick up a project. Just for interest. Remember, it won't directly help you in your short-term internship or placement selection. DSA is the primary thing that might help you. Once your internship or placement selection is over, then I would say give your whole day to building your development skills, because that will help you to build a great project if in case you are sitting in another interview someday, and also will definitely help you being a good developer, which will help you in actual job. Now people say that companies teach people the work they want, but it's because they have to. If you already know good development, then obviously it's better for you, you will grow faster in your job. So once that placement or internship season is over, focus on development completely. The third, CGPA. Whatever you have done, it's okay, it's good, it's okay, it's bad, it's okay, it doesn't matter now. For future, focus more on DSA, focus more on project, but then give some time for CGPA. I mean, I am also a college student, I very well know that even if you study a few days before exam, you can get a decent CGPA. So don't just throw it away saying that it doesn't matter, and don't like study full semester saying that okay, CGPA is all that matters. So I guess this video helped. If you want to see more such videos, then subscribe to the channel as always, and do like and share with your friends who will be sitting in their internship season or placement season. And as I said, if you want to add something more, or if you think that I said something wrong, do let me know in the comments. If you have any other thoughts also, do let me know in the comments. I would love to read your comments. And see you next time. Bye bye.